Welcome back, Moffat County football fans. Getting ready to start the third quarter here at Bulldog Proving Grounds. We want to say thanks to our sponsors, Chaos Inc., Identity Graphics, and Young Life, and our Moffat County Proud supporters, Mountain West Insurance and Financial Services, Cook Chevrolet, and Rocky Mountain Automotive. So, Shane, what did you think about that first half?
Well, you know, Kip, first off, what a beautiful evening now turning into night. The game so far has had that an interesting ebb and flow. It started out, we made a big mistake. Our defense turned around, got it back. We almost scored. We had a penalty, take a touchdown off the board. And then it just back and forth. And at the end, we got that one big score. Exciting game. A lot of individual players really shining tonight in our line. Our offensive and defensive line playing great. Steamboat having two or three guys everywhere.
And two big turnovers for the Bulldogs. We're able to convert one of those into points. All right, we're ready to go. Third quarter action. Back deep to receive for the Sailors is Kaminsky and Joe DeLine. There's a kick by Lloyd, gonna get a good roll. Just sit right there, and it does. That's where you want it. Bulldogs are gonna smother him right there around the 10. DeLine makes a good second effort and pulls it out to about the 14. If that ball in high school football touches that goal line, automatic whistle, ball's going to the 20.
We had Caden Hafey down there, one of those first guys.
Right on. Good job, Caden Hafey, getting down there. All right, so Bulldogs will come out on defense, trying to preserve the shutout here in the second half. Great first half defensive football by both squads.
Well, and here, another one of those sayings you always hear that's true is that coaches earn their money after half. Who makes the better adjustments?
All right, Matt Hansen still at quarterback for the Sailors. Sailors spread it out. Got a stacked receiver over there with Kaminsky. He'll come in motion, likes to do that. Bring it across. Bad snap. Oh, and it almost got away from him. Bad snap, but Hansen was able to just pull it in with his right hand and maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Wow, so right away you had in there, we had number 33, Wyatt Johnson or Jefferson Piot.
And actually, I think that's JT Perulis in there, number 33. Got about three kids with jersey number 33 on the roster.
Well, then for sure JT Perulis, and you had Klimper on the bottom of that pile. They got him from the top and the bottom. Nice play.
Yeah, one of those things when you check out the roster and it says number 33, number 33, and number 33.
A lot of love for 33.
You had a 33% chance. Right on. All right, so here we go. All right, Bulldogs. It actually ends up being a one-yard loss. Steamboat Springs goes trips receivers to the near side with that wing. They always put two wide. Kaminsky likes to go in motion, near side. Inside receiver still uncovered. We were wondering about that second half. They'll motion across. Hadley steps in. Bad snap again, and there's not much that Hansen can do with it. He tries to make something out of nothing. When you get a bad snap, it throws all your timing off. Hansen does a good job, man. If one of those get by him, that's maybe a touchdown Bulldogs.
And then right away, just that little extra second it took to get that snap, you had Stelios Perulis in there, and Klimper again. And we're seeing what we've been wondering about. Steamboat wants to exploit this right now. When Steamboat has two guys lined up here to the, I don't call it east, and then when one of them goes in motion, if he does not go in motion, it seems as though the only guy covering him is the deep safety.
And you got a hitch route there, you got an inside slant, but Steamboat's not calling it. And you'll see it happen right here. So you got Shandon up on the near receiver, other inside receiver uncovered, the safety's back off 12. That's where you hit your hitch. But they go in motion, we shift to it. Keenan Hildebrand on the near side end. Shotgun pass, releases the back. Up comes Connor Scranton, almost picks it off. Good coverage, way to break on the ball, Connor Scranton. In comes the punt return team for the Bulldogs.
And they answered our question there, Kip. They showed what we were wondering, what they would do in that situation. Well, they dropped that guy coming underneath, and Scranton closed like a demon. Hadley was there underneath of that, and we actually were in great position to make a play.
All right, Bulldogs will put two guys deep. Looks like we have Connor Scranton, and you got a number on that, Shane?
I just can't.
Maybe Dylan Kincaid?
Yes, sir.
There's the punt. Oh, it's not Dylan Kincaid. It's Ryan Zimmerman. Ryan Zimmerman come up, makes a good block. Connor bounces off a guy. He breaks it to the outside. Oh, and another one comes in for the quick tackle. Good job, Connor Scranton. Breaks that tackle. It about went, man. He about busted it. Good job. Ryan Zimmerman coming up, making a good block as a personal protector on that after he didn't get the kickoff the punt.
It took us a second to figure out who was back there, but my goodness, he let himself be known. When he did not get the ball, some guys will let up. And Ryan Zimmerman did get it, and he went and crunched somebody, made a key block. Now it looks let's see here. Looks like we're going backwards.
I think we got a block below the waist. One of those things, mental mistakes, man, and that hurts because you got the ball at midfield starting the second half, and now you're going to back it up 15 yards. Well, it's going to be a 10-yarder. So 10-yard penalty, Moffat County starting out on the 36-yard line.
So mistakes, kind of the way it is early in the season, especially a 0 week. And now the only positive here, instead of first and 20, it is first and 10, just further back, if I'm not mistaken, yes.
Hey, want to say thanks to all our Go Big Blue sponsors, Chaos Inc., Identity Graphics, and Young Life. All right, Keenan Hildebrandt back in to start this second half under center. Double wing formation, takes the snap. We got a sweep to the left. Hadley makes a guy miss, gets to the corner, and gets about 3, maybe 4.
Good positive yardage, and you got to love that when the point of contact, so far you've seen that all of our running backs cover with both hands, deal 4 points of possession, not fumbling the ball and putting their body down low and falling forward.
All right, linemen will look at the wristbands, got the play from Coach Gilly. Bulldogs go double wing.
Positive yardage, looks like actually, yeah, real close to 5 yards on that last play.
Want to continue this drive going. Got to move that ball on the ground. We got jet sweep to the right. And Eddie tries to make one guy miss. Gets tackled. Shoestring tackle by the cornerback, number 15. Also their quarterback, Matt Hansen. And we're going to get a holding call on the Bulldogs, and it's going to back up another 10.
I think in the way they threw that flag right at the feet of Stelios and the way he seems a little upset with himself, that was one right in front of the official. And now, gosh, your drive, you've got such a good drive going. You were going to be third and, I don't know, 4 or 3, and now you just move backwards and you keep shooting yourself in the foot.
We talked about it early season mistakes. Bulldogs actually played really well in the first half. Not very many mistakes, but right now, two penalties right in a row. They put themselves in a hole. We got second and long. We just need to get a chunk of this. We don't need it all now. Just need a chunk of it. Double wing. Steamboat bringing 5 to the line. 2 backers and 3 deep. Option to the right. Nothing there. Swarm of sailors shuts it down. No gain.
Well, and some of the same culprits there for Steamboat making that play. Number 59 has been all over the place with Liam Hong. You had Jake Hustleton. And also 21 in there, who's been all over the field tonight for Steamboat. DeLine playing a heck of a game. Now third and Meeker, basically.
Yeah, it's a long ways. All right, Bulldogs will line it up. Double wing with a split. Split to the far side. That'll be Kern Gerber out to the far side. Eddie Smersina goes in motion, going away. We got a pass. Hildebrandt's going to put it up. He's got him open in the middle. Overthrow. Little bit too much on it. Keenan not happy with himself on that. Knows he had a guy. Keenan's got a great arm, just needs to sit there, take a deep breath, come back in and get it done. Great kid, hard worker, and just a load. I love it when Keenan runs the ball. I like it when Keenan runs the ball. Hasn't done that much tonight. I love seeing him run, man. He moves the pile. Would like to see more of that.
Well, what happened, Coach, was when you're in those situations where penalties make it so everybody knows you're going to pass, it's a lot harder, obviously. And he had a guy streaking open there. He just missed it.
All right, Brett Lloyd gets off a good punt, punts it away from DeLine. Going to go out of bounds. Looks like around, as the referee walks it up, I'm thinking 37-yard line.
The one where the net isn't the greatest. No gain, a whole bunch of field position there, but let's turn around and play some defense now.
All right, Bulldogs will come back. It is 8:18 left, 7-0. 8:18 left in the third. Steamboat Springs, second possession of the second half. Ball on the 37-yard line. Bulldog defense came out strong. A 3-and-out on the last series. You got Kern Gerber back at safety. Shandon Hadley at corner. At the other corner, Smersina. Linebackers, JT Perulis, Mickey Klimper, and Brett Lloyd. At the ends, you got Tuttle and Perulis. In the middle, Kuhn and Frankie Masterson. Quick little slip screen on the inside. Kaminsky makes a couple guys miss, makes a good run, but we're going to get a penalty.
There was an early, early penalty too. Whatever happens later, there was one on them right off the bat. I think they had motion or their guy was lined up offsides.
I think illegal formation or illegal motion. I think you got it because that flag came quick. Tried a little slip screen by the Sailors. And it's going to be a motion call. It'll be repeat first down, and it'll be first and 15.
And you can see right now how frustrated they are, Kip, because they're seeing the things that we saw earlier, and we can hear some of the coaches across from us. They are trying to exploit those things that they have seen in the first half going on, and they're making these little mistakes every time they try to do that. They just can't quite get it right. And here, pretty soon, we're going to tighten that up more and more. That's not going to be there.
No, and you know what? I've just been really, really happy with our defense so far in this game. They've just held strong. Maybe one big play they gave up, but other than that, man, they have held strong, and that's what they got to continue. We got a tight game, folks. 7-0, 8-10 left. Steamboat Springs will go two wide to the near side. One left. Back in shotgun. Number 15, Matt Hansen. There's the run right up the middle, and it's a bunch of Bulldogs on top there. Frankie Masterson and Mickey Klimper looking to be in on that. Yeah. Trevor Kuhn, maybe a yard gain.
Again, how about the inside of our defensive line, Coach? They are dominating up front. Nothing there like running into a brick wall.
All right, Bulldogs, keep it up. Like to see that. You know, I mean, the kids just playing right now, playing really, really disciplined. They're doing their job, and that's what you got to remember. When you start worrying about everybody else's jobs, and then that's usually when you make a mistake. So do your job and count on your teammates. All right, Steamboat Springs will go wide to the far side with two receivers, bringing in the slot. Here comes Kaminsky in motion. Looks like a jet sweep, but it's a fake. Oh! Quarterback will keep it. Goes up the middle. Gain of about two. Good job, defense. If they would have handed the jet sweep, he would have been swarmed. So both guys covered. Great job, Bulldog defense.
How about the job tonight that Bryce Tuttle has done? You see right there, if that ball, like you said, if it is handed off, he crushed that jet sweep guy. And so now they're not going to come back to that. There was nothing there. Just cross that play off.
That's right. All right, third and long. Coach is bringing in some subs.
See who came in here.
Looks like you got Keenan Hildebrandt, Ryan Zimmerman, and Caden Hafey coming in. Passing situation brought in an extra DB. Third and 11. Here comes motion. Snap to Hansen. We got a bootleg. He's coming in the near side. He's got a receiver wide open. Breaking up hard, and they're going to get a first down. I think he's got enough. They slipped that receiver underneath.
Holding on Steamboat.
And we got holding on Steamboat, bringing it back.
Once again, every once in a while, touche, they say. A little bit of luck helps.
All right. Steamboat, nice play. They slipped that guy out, came across, found the open part in the zone. Good route, good catch. Would have had a first down. Get called for the hold and brings it back. And we'll do it again. It's going to be third and 20.
Well, and just like we said, Kip, they finally – were able to do what they wanted against that defense. They did a phenomenal job. They got Hadley deep on their receiver who had to stay with him, had slipped a receiver underneath who ran a great route right in front of the sticks to get that first down. Beautiful, but back here, sometimes a guy holds because he has to. I believe you had Stelios Perulas bearing down on their quarterback and he had to hold him or he was gonna get his quarterback knocked out.
All right, Steamboat Springs comes back to the near side with three receivers. They like to line up in that trips receiver with that wing. Kaminsky in motion again. He'll bring it all the way across the formation. Inside handoff, bootleg coming out. Looks like almost the same play. He's going to go deep. Connor Scranton reads the ball. There's a pick. And he'll run it back for about six. Turnover. Bulldogs on the attack.
How about this? Hadley had the receiver underneath, released him to the safety, Scranton, who did a great job of taking the route, stepping up on the receiver and makes the interception. Those corners tonight have been stout. You've had Hadley, you've had Gerber, you've had Scranton, and you've had Smorsina. Our four corners and safeties have done a great job.
All right, got a player down on the field. Looks like maybe got the wind knocked out of him. Glad to see him get up. never like to see a kid get hurt. All these kids playing hard and play because they love the game. You know, that's great memories. So glad to see he's okay. Huge play, Connor Scranton. Great job. Like to see that, him breaking on the ball like that. All right, Bulldogs threatening. They got the momentum. Let's drive it in, boys. We got first down, 26-yard line, third quarter, 6:08 left.
Let's see now.
Brett Lloyd comes back, and coach says, no, get back out there. You're not coming out, son. All right. And
big number,
and looks like we got a and good call by coach. You don't want to get an illegal participation penalty. So coach calls timeout. We want to thank our sponsors for tonight's game, Chaos Inc., Identity Graphics, and Young Life, and also our supporters, Mountain West Insurance Financial Services, Cook Chevrolet, and Rocky Mountain Automotive. We got a timeout on the field. We'll be back in a moment. You're listening to and you're watching MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM Bulldog Football on the Go Big Blue Network. So line up in the double wing motion to Lloyd. Handoff to Lloyd. Not much there. Maybe a yard, maybe two.
Having talked to some of the coaching staff, their idea is now at this point in the game, they would love to just be able to pound the rock with Lloyd over and over now and at this tired defense.
Well, and Shane, you know what I haven't seen? When they brought early, when we had that first scoring drive, we spread out. We went double wing, but we put two wide outs, and that seemed to work. Haven't seen that this half yet. Under center, Hildebrandt. Motion Hadley. Going the other way. Hadley's going to try to get to the edge. He makes a nice cut. He breaks it. He's going for the end zone. He's down to the four. Looked like there was nothing there, but that's that speed from Shandon Hadley. He's definitely got some speed, and he can get out of there.
And Sam Berman and Peyton McElhaney with the saving touchdown tackle on Hadley, but a little bit of a wiggle and a juke for that play.
Absolutely. Good run, Shandon Hadley. Not much there. Made something out of nothing. Great speed with that kid. All right, Bulldogs first and goal from the four. Double wing. Motion Lloyd. There's the pitch to Lloyd. He's going to bulldoze it in, and he's in. Almost untouched. Great block by that right side of the line. Hugo Hernandez, Stelios Perulis, and Trevor Kuhn. Tight end Kern Gerber blowing a hole for Lloyd.
Great job there, and as they say, the wheels on the bus go round and round.
All right. Also had Elias Perulis in there helping open that up for Lloyd.
Very, very big play. The last two plays, in fact, coach. We set that up with a nice long run, and then we bring in the pounder and pound it in.
Yeah, and momentum is a dangerous thing. And big interception by Connor Scranton leading to this touchdown. Extra point, call it good. Moffat County 14, Steamboat Springs 0. 5 minutes and 20 seconds left in the third. Great job, boys. We'll be right back. This is Bulldog Football on MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM on the Go Big Blue Network. MOFFAT County High School, where the Bulldogs score here with 5:20 left in the third. Want to say thanks to our MOFFAT County Proud supporters, Mountain West Insurance Financial Services, Cook Chevrolet, and Rocky Mountain Automotive, and our Go Big Blue sponsors, Chaos Inc., Identity Graphics, and Young Life. Would love to have you be a sponsor and partner together with us. Click on the contact button on MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM and let us know. All right. Brett Lloyd kicking off. DeLine receiving. Big wall of Sailors up the middle. DeLine looking to break it. Good return, Sailors, as he brings it out to the 40.
30. So we had number 30, which was Elias Perulis, and 33, John T. Perulis, the two Perulis boys in on that tackle.
All right, Bulldog D coming out. Steamboat Springs with good field position. Ball's going to be spotted at the 39.
And this is the point where I, as a player, and I was in my son and my nephew's ear, Mackenzie Klimper, and I said, remember what they've done to you in the past. Remember what they did to you 2 years ago, 3 years ago. Now, don't let up. Don't let off the throttle.
All right, Moffat County setting up in that forefront defense. Bunch formation to the near side. We got a pitch. The line running. He's got some room. He's going to get a few, but great pursuit by the Bulldogs. Coming up fast, Shandon Hadley and Elias Perulis, and they'll shut it down. Looked like it could be a potential big gain. Ends up only being a few.
Yeah, you know, Shannon put his head in there. Hadley came down low, and then you had Perulis finish the job. And I thought it was going to be much more yardage than that. Ends up being 3 yards.
Closed fast. Good pursuit by the Bulldogs. Steamboat Springs struggling right now in the second half to get anything going. Haven't had a first down in the third quarter. Trips receivers near side. Look for Kaminsky in motion. He'll bring it across to the wide side. Doubles receivers. They're going to throw it. They got him on the bubble screen. Up comes Eddie Smersina. Great coverage. And followed up by number 11, Connor Scranton, cleaning it up. And it's a loss of a few.
How about that? He just took him to pile driver town.
Right on. Great job, defensive backs. All right. Moffat County. Defense just tearing it up.
Yes, sir. Right there when you finish, you say, welcome to Suplex City.
All right, we got third and 10. Ball's on the 40, 39-yard line.
Here we go. Big play, big play.
All right, Steamboat Springs lines it up. Trips to the near side. Expect the pass. DBs have to be ready. Kaminsky in motion. Brings it across. Looks to be a jet sweep. He'll fake it. Run quarterback draw up the middle. He's going to get about three. Not near enough. And Steamboat Springs is going to have to line it up and punt it to the Bulldogs.
You know, good solid defense there. When you've got third and that long, of course, you want them running up the middle. So you shut down the outside, the option, and you can have your 5 yards. And now you're 6 yards short, 5 yards short of your first down midfield here. They're punting away.
Hey, look to Steamboat. Don't be surprised if they run a fake. They've already ran one. DeLine likes to run with it before he punts it. 2:57 left in the third. Yep. Steamboat Springs missing a player. He'll run on late. Set up to punt. Back deep for the Bulldogs. One man. DeLine takes it running to the right. Almost has it blocked again. Gets it down the field. He's going to get a great roll. Good decision by the Bulldogs. They'll just step away. You don't want to pick that up with a bunch of red around. Good punt by DeLine. He barely got that off. He almost held it too long.
Now explain to me, Coach, here on those plays, when he holds it that long, how do you not have an illegal man downfield?
It doesn't have to be. It's not a pass. Yeah, not a, on any type of a punt play, they can, every single lineman can run down the field on those special teams plays. On a pass play, can't. If DeLine was going to throw that ball and he threw it and there would have been linemen downfield, yes, it would have been illegal man downfield.
Okay, so at that point, if you're the guys dropping back and you see the entire line has exited, he has to punt.
He has to punt or run. Has to punt or run. Not going to pass it, though. So call that about a 45-yard punt. Good punt for the Sailors. Bulldogs going to start on about the 15. In motion goes Lloyd. He'll take it to the right. Breaks the first tackle. Breaks the second tackle. Bulldogs ahead. Nice hard running. Because that would, I mean, if Lloyd doesn't break tackles there, it's probably a loss of one. Good run, Brett Lloyd, 4 yard gain.
So right now, 2 minutes, 23 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Bulldogs up 14-0, and they're using their big pounder right now. Brett Lloyd turns that into 5 or 6 yards, powerful running.
Would love to see a big drive here by the Bulldogs. Let's go, 85-yard drive for a touchdown. Let's see what we can do. Good first down play. Motion Hadley, he'll go to the edge. Boom, makes the guy miss. We knew that was going to happen. He's been doing it all night. Keeps running, shaking and baking, and gets a 10-yard gain and another first down for the Bulldogs.
Nice run. And we were talking earlier, Kip, Shannon looks fast, and he's being decisive. One cut running downhill, so we pounded him with the big back. Then we hit him with the speed back, and there you go. First down, minute 54 left in the third quarter.
All right. Bulldogs got a drive going. That was a big play, got him out of that hole. You don't ever like being down there inside that 20 on your own side of the field. So, good play, Bulldogs. First down, ball on the 30. Double wing formation. Bulldogs love that double wing. Motion goes Lloyd. Counter back, Smersina. Breaks the tackle. He's to the 50, 40. No one's going to catch him. He's to the 20. He's to the 10. Call it a touchdown, Moffat County. Let's go, Bulldog football.
Just like that, folks, we hit him with the left. We hit him with the right. Uppercut, knockout.
Great run. He got the edge. He broke some tackles. Did a little bit of everything. And the Bulldogs strike again with 1:27 left in the third.
And we all remember the old saying, speed kills.
Great job. The offense looking good this half. Two quick touchdowns. Struggled a little bit in the first half, but man, they're starting to get it. It's opening up. That's what we want to see, that tough double wing run game. There's a snap, fumbled snap. That extra point's not going to happen. Keenan just has to hold on to it, and he's taken down. Bulldogs up 20-0 in the third quarter. It's Moffat County tearing it up here in the third quarter. You're watching Bulldog football on MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM, brought to you by the Go Big Blue Network. Great drive, Shane, but we didn't get a drive, but we got a big play. We've been waiting for that. Haven't had one of those. About an 85. Well, I think we're on about the 30, so call it a 70-yard run for Eddie Smersina. Great job, Bulldogs.
Beautiful, beautiful. Like we said, it was thunder, lightning, and then one last lightning strike. Left, right, left, right. You're toothless.
All right, kickoff deep by Lloyd. Number five breaking it up the middle. Another big return for the Sailors. That's Peyton McKinley. Made a good move, got a good return.
So Elias Perulis and Dominic Paschetti in on that one. Dominic finding a way to make an impact, making a special teams tackle. And if you're not playing on the offense or defense, you get in there and make some tackles on special teams. That's how you make that team.
All right. Don't be surprised if the Sailors start trying to put the ball in the air.
Yep, the cornerbacks need to get on their toes and ready to fly.
Steamboat Springs trips to the wide side, far side of the field. Always in the gun. Haven't seen him run anything else this game. Another bad snap. Has to give it to DeLine. DeLine pops outside. He's trying to make something out of nothing, and he does, and he gets about five.
Good tackle. Once again now, Smersina is everywhere.
Great job, Bulldogs. And Frankie, you know, up the middle. He has just been a terror on the center and smacks him every time, and they've had some tough snaps because of it. Great pressure by the D-line.
Defense looking phenomenal. And now what we're seeing, Coach, we are doing, like they're doing the NFL now. We're platooning our running backs now. We've got some good ones. Back on defense now, the same guys are out there doing the job on defense.
Steamboat Springs with trips to the far side. Kaminsky comes in motion. He'll stop it up short. Tried a little counter reverse there inside. He's maybe going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Bulldogs pick him up clean in the air. And not much there. Maybe a yard.
Wouldn't know that was a wrestler there, huh? Double leg straight to his back, down to the ground. Say hello to Brent Lloyd.
All right, that's probably going to run out the third quarter as we got 10 seconds left. And that'll be the end of the third quarter. Moffat County up 20-0. Want to say thanks to our Go Big Blue sponsors, Chaos Inc., Identity Graphics, and Young Life. We'll be right back with Bulldog football and the fourth quarter. This is MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM on the Go Big Blue Network.